What's up? This is Nathan from Sonic Syndicate, and you're listening to Metal Wani and Metalholic Magazine.
Mr. Nathan, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm doing great. Wow, man, after such a long time, you guys are back with a new album. I mean, what can I say? Sonic Syndicate, a new journey has begun. Congratulations.
Well, it took bloody long enough, I can tell you that.
Absolutely. So, now, how does it feel to be releasing a new album, you know, after the hiatus?
Yeah, really, really good. I mean, we're all so happy about it, you know. We really got that kind of hungry, nervous, energetic kind of feeling, you know, like when you start a band kind of thing.
Right.
So, yeah, I mean, more than anything, we love playing live and, you know, and
True.
Touring and stuff and playing shows. That's kind of the thing that we all have in common, you know.
Right.
And having a new album allows us to do that, and we get to, like, you know, try out these new songs live now and experience the whole roller coaster all over again.
Right, absolutely true. Now, you guys have maintained the integrity of the genre, you know, but still you've played with a lot of elements on this album. Now, at this point of time, I kind of felt that it has been a long road for you guys. I mean, there's been a change in the sound, the members, and, you know, even in the name in the beginning. So, is it more like reintroducing yourselves into the world of heavy metal?
Not really. Mm-hmm. I think, if anything, it's we're back to make sure that people are looking after metal.
Right.
As in, you know, it's been over 2 years since we've done an album, 3 years or more.
Right.
2011, We Rule the Night came out, and, you know, then we were straying away from, like, the, you know, the melodic death metal, metalcore kind of genre, and we were kind of just trying some new things, really experimenting with melody, and that was amazing, and it's really added, like, a huge dynamic to our live set as well. But, you know, we've always said that we are a heavy metal band, and, you know, we're always going to be a heavy metal band, and who knows what we'll do with the next album. And as a result, you know, the feeling was right for us to do a more, I don't want to say generic album, mm-hmm. but it's certainly paying, like, homage to the roots of the genre this time, you know.
Absolutely.
Playing a lot with, like, the Swedish sound and the death metal sound and the metalcore, and playing around with, like, our influences that got us into metal. And
Absolutely.
So, yeah, I mean, there's been a big kind of bleeding of genres recently, you know, with the,
right,
whatever you want to call it, progressive death metal or post-grindcore, I don't
know, right.
Kind of stemmed from the metalcore, and, you know, they've taken on this grindcore element, and stuff has got, it's don't get me wrong, it's produced some absolutely amazing fucking bands.
True.
That I love, like Suicide Silence and Whitechapel and
Altial Perish and so on.
Bring Me the Horizon as well. They're absolutely amazing bands and really powerful live. But at the same time, it just seems to be okay just to do this, as long as it's got fast triggered drums and, you know, really
vocals,
and then some beatdowns, then it's classified, oh, it's a good band. And I'm just like, that's bullshit, you know, let's write some proper metal. And, you know, fair enough, the bands that are fucking awesome like that, I'm a huge Whitechapel fan and Bring Me the Horizon fan, I love where they've taken the genre, but, you know, there's a little bit too much bullshit out there, and we wanted to just come back with a really solid album and, you know, show some of the younger bands how it's done, maybe.
That's the reason there's no dull moment on this album. Now, there's an element of surprise in the album as well. It's a surprise because I can expect an album to take, let's say, this route, and instead of expecting a speed, I kind of get that creaky, you know, tone which goes into my, you know, that kind of a tranquility effect. So you guys have spent a lot of time in terms of arrangements on this album, like how you guys want to flow, how the music is going to flow for the entire, right from the beginning till the end. So how has been this journey of writing songs?
I don't know, maybe it sounds a bit more together because of it. I mean, basically, we stopped, you know, touring in 2011, and we
right.
kind of went on a break then. And in that time, obviously, Corin, bass player, and John, the drummer, had kids with their husband and wife.
Right.
And but in that time, we never lost touch for a start, and me and Robin especially, the whole time we were kind of just passing ideas back and forth to each other. So quite a few of the songs, I'd say like about five of the songs on the album, grew really gradually. You know, they were ideas for a long time, and we kind of just, you know, got them to a stage demo-wise where we thought they sounded together and stuff, and then and then we showed them to the rest of the guys in the band and worked on them. And it kind of just grew from there. And then, you know, when we're just like, okay, let's fucking go to the studio, then we kind of, you know, really whipped them into shape and, you know, as well as some new ideas. And
that's wonderful. Now, Robin has been the main composer of the band, and of course, you, your contribution to the album as well. So in terms of the lyrical approach, what's the route this time on Sonic Syndicate?
Anytime I kind of write about lyrics, it's usually based on like personal experience. There's a number of things on this album. Being like, I'm from the UK and stuff, and obviously I've moved away from home and certain groups of friends and stuff. There's a couple of songs on there that that explore like intense kind of betrayal and stuff, and kind of, you know, people leaving you and things like that. A very close friend to my family died of cancer. The only kind of slower song on the album, that Unbreakable track, that's like paying tribute to her. So yeah, very, very real, honest issues. Also kind of like an overall message of why it's a bit darker. I mean, I wanted it to be dark, but at the same time uplifting. And, you know, I think we've always done that with our choruses and stuff, but, I think as an overall kind of feeling, if I had to give, like, you know, the string of red tape that ran through the album, what is kind of major feeling there, emotion-wise, it would probably be that we go through this life and we meet a lot of people who are, you know, they say they're your friends or whatever, and they'll always be there for you, and we collect people, not necessarily people just trying to be a friend, but we collect people and we surround ourselves with things and people that we don't necessarily need. And the kind of the theme being focus more in life on what you need, not what you want.
Brilliant. Now that's really cool about, because there are a lot of dark elements and the light elements which are, you know, filtered smoothly throughout the album. So It's a great journey, I would say. I mean, listening to the album from beginning till the end, it's a different feeling altogether. And of course, we have, you know, Speed making a guest appearance as well. Now, Swedish Blood, man, you guys unleash hell, and that video kills. So how was the arrangement? I mean, how did that come into the picture? How was Speed introduced on this album?
Well, it kind of started off in that I was writing that song and I was just putting like a shitload of lyrics in it. And I was just like, it'd be, you know, we used to be a two vocalist band, to have like a little bit in there on this album, it'd be really fun to have like a guest vocalist with us. And believe it or not, funny story, me and Speed were friends even before I knew Sonic Syndicate. Soilwork were touring the UK, I think it was like in 2004 or 2005 or something. We met up and we actually did some vocal tuition together, and we kind of kept in touch after that. And then when I moved to Sweden, we carried on being in touch. And of course, Sonic Syndicate, we've got a firm history together as well. We played countless festivals together, on tour together. And not only that, like, as I was saying, this album does have like a homage to the roots of like the Swedish sound. And, you know, hands up, Soilwork. Best fucking bands that have pioneered that genre and, like, you know, really carved out a niche for it. And between that and knowing that we wanted to have a guest vocalist, and he's one of my favorite vocalists in the world, it was just like, we knew exactly who we were going to get as soon as we decided we wanted to have some guest songs.
Awesome.
To elaborate on that a little bit, you remember when you were probably, how old are you?
I'm around 27.
Yeah, I'm 27 as well. No, I just turned 28, actually. That's fun. So you remember maybe when you were growing up, it would have been the 90s and stuff, when there was that big resurgence of metal, you know, like Soulfly and Slipknot and things like that, Deftones. You remember when Corey Taylor guested on that song with Soulfly, that Jump the Fuck Up song.
Right, the first album of Soulfly.
Yeah, or when...
That's around 1998.
Maynard, Maynard guest vocals with Chino Moreno on the Deftones,
right.
The Passenger song. Basically, that seemed to go on a lot more when I was younger, it felt. Uh-huh. And I remember being a kid and just having two of my favorite vocalists on one fucking song. I was just like, wow, this is amazing.
Absolutely.
So I guess the little kid in me wanted to kind of give that to our generation of fans because, you know, I imagine us and Soilwork share a lot of the same fan base. So
true.
I just thought it would be awesome for the fans as well.
Wonderful, man. Now, for every album a band releases, there are always mixed feelings from the fans and the critics. So, you know, whenever releasing a new album... Sorry?
So that's what the critics are there for.
Absolutely. Now, like, you know, media obviously will have mixed feelings about the quality. Now, while good reviews are great, they boost the morale of the band. Sometimes a less favorable review, does it, you know, affect the band for you guys? Or is it more like, we do whatever we, you know, whatever we want and we're going to give it to our fans? Is it that sort of an approach? Or is it like, will fans, you know, listen to our material? Is it, you know, a different approach we have done? So how do you guys, you know, proclaim that?
Basically, I always look at it with a completely open mind. Haters seem to love to hate.
Haters gonna hate.
No matter whether you're watching a fucking trailer on YouTube or a band's new music video, there's always these little trolls that just love to fucking spam fucking hatred at you. And it's just, anything, it's more than funny. But, you know, being in a band and being, like, responsible for music and fans that are behind you and stuff, you do take a certain amount of responsibility, so you gotta try and keep an open mind. And I always just sit there with just like, anybody says anything negative, that's their opinion and they're totally up for it. And you know, whilst we want as many people to stay with us and listen to our music and, you know, get new fans and stuff, if the band's not for you, then you can say what the fuck you want and go listen to another band, you know. Those
Absolutely.
Aren't the people that are important to us. You know, the people that are important to us, the people that love the music and, you know, the people around us, like our friends, our fans, our record label. And, you know, the support for this record's been overwhelming. So
that's awesome.
Any negativity doesn't bother me.
That's brilliant. That's what the musician is all about. Respect others' opinion, whether it's, you know, helping you or not. At the same time, you guys are known to, you know, to pack a punch on each and every album. But the lineup change has also, you know, done...
Well, we've got some lineup changes and we also do something different on every album, you
True.
Know. And that, you know, makes us a very special band for some people. And it, you know, it upsets a few people at the same time. But, you know, the music wheel keeps on turning and, you know, we're a part of it.
Absolutely. Now, I mean, you've known Robin for from last 6 years or 5 years, or maybe even before that. I'm not sure about that. So you
2008.
Got 2008. Okay. So you joined the band in 2009. So the journey, you know, these 5 year journey with the band, with the two albums that have come out. So how do you look at it? And is there something which you felt that, you know, you could have achieved in terms of your vocals or your songwriting and you want to, you know, pick it up and improve on the next albums?
What are you asking me? Vocal wise?
Yeah, in terms of your own contribution to the music of the band.
I think it's just evolved kind of gradually. I mean, you know, I started off just wanting to do metal music and stuff, but as the years have gone on, I've had like vocal lessons. I've done like songwriting with, you know, people from different record labels, lots of different musicians, and I guess I've kind of taken a lot more pride in myself.
Awesome.
And my work. And so every single time I do an album, I try to better myself, being it, you know, this album, for example, I've really, you know, tried to work on my heavier vocals. I've just not wanted to do any heavy vocals. You know, I've really kind of done some weird stuff with the syncopation. Like I've done some really fast little, like almost like raps almost, but like with the heavy stuff, trying to hit loads of different beats. And
awesome.
So yeah, I want to do, yeah, just keep pushing myself. And the more I can be a part of the songwriting, the better I get, the more I can be a part of the songwriting with, you know, Robin and the rest of the guys. And Yeah.
Wonderful, man. And so that brings me to the question, which is going to be the first track that you guys are going to unleash live? I mean, it's difficult to choose, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it obviously makes sense to play some of the stuff that people have heard already. People have heard Black Hole Halo and
Before You Finally Break, right.
And we've got some, we've actually got a show next week in Germany, and we're going to play those two songs live for the very first time.
Awesome.
And we've got about, I don't know, 6 or 7 festivals, I think, before, between July and August. So we're going to play, you know, a great mixture of songs from the previous albums at those shows, and also those two new songs. Then when we come to the Diabolical Tour of Art, that we're doing a headline tour in October, November, starting then, we're going to be booking shows into next year as well. So we're still booking shows, but then we're going to talk about which more songs from the new album we want to play and mix
it
up.
Wow, man, that's phenomenal. You have a jam-packed, you know, year ahead, and then 2015 as well. So, you know, I'm just asking this question a bit more early, but you know, what's the future goals of Sonic Syndicate apart from tour? Of course, you guys are going to unleash live. So apart from that, what are the future goals of the, you know, are there any rock star dreams that are yet to be fulfilled?
I'm doing pretty well. Just to keep going. I mean, I'd love to go. I suppose the main thing is come to some territories where we haven't been before or haven't been in a very long time. We want to go back to the USA and Japan again, but we also want to go to places like India and Australia as well is a big one that we want to go to. So, yeah, I guess just playing some of the places around the world that we haven't, and just keep growing more fans and more friends and stuff.
Wonderful, man. I just hope to see you guys live in India, probably maybe this year, maybe next year, but there are melodic death metal fans. We haven't had a chance to witness many Swedish bands. We've seen Meshuga, we have seen Opeth coming in here, but Sonic Syndicate, okay. So we're just patient enough to wait for it. So,
well, if you know any festivals or, you know, the big booking agents there, then try to send us some information and we can see what we can make happen.
That's wonderful. I can definitely do that. I have floating in contact anytime, so I can do that. Wonderful, brother. So if I have to end the interview by asking you a simple question. Sonic Syndicate, self-titled album, if you got to define it in just one sentence.
Diabolical work of art.
There we go. I was expecting you to hit the nail, and you definitely did it, man. Thanks, Nathan. It's been an honor to have you. You spent some precious time today with us. Really appreciate it.
No problem. Drop us a message when your review's up, okay?
Definitely. And you like to give us a station ID?